Welcome to JuanOnOne Spotlight. Thanks for following us from Parahal, Bayanihan, at Samahan to hashtag One Step Forward to right now, JuanOnOne Spotlight. Know that we are enjoying this time we have with you, the FM jocks, the artists, and the whole production crew. Basically, we're here to lift your spirits with great music and bring your favorite Filipino musicians closer to you. This special is brought to you by the radio stations under the Philippine Broadcasting Service. Republika FM 1, FM 1 Davao, Capital FM 2, RP1 and RP2. Today, we will get to know more about this beautiful person who grew up before our very eyes and ears. She hit the music scene by storm as a teenager, come on, body ager, and through the years captured everyone's hearts like the firewoman that she is. And now our admiration grows as we watch her go about her life as wife and mother, music being the center of her existence still. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for Barbie Almalbis Onasan. Woo! Okay, I'm still
Thank
not
you
used to
all these. Thanks for having me.
You know what, Barbie, all these years, I'm still not used to calling you Barbie Onasan. So may Almalbis pa rin talaga.
I still use Barbie Almalbis when I do music stuff because it's so, my husband din said, parang ang haba masyado. It's so long.
Okay, so before we go to the question and answer portion, okay, let's start now. Random facts you probably don't know. Yeah, you probably haven't said this in any of your interviews in the past.
Okay. Well, first of all, I'm a very handy person. Like, I'm the handy woman in the house. I know how to solder. I can work a drill. And I like fixing stuff. Like, my kids come to me when their toys are broken and I have to, you know, put WD-40 or... Ganyan. I like being handy.
Really?
Yeah, I have a toolbox. I have a few toolboxes and I have, like, a tool table where I solder and fix my guitars. There.
So, yung nag 9.9 sale online, puro tools yung binili mo sa cart mo. I'm just yeah, pwede, no? Okay, next.
I love bread. It's my favorite thing to eat in Ooh. The world. And this quarantine, that's the first new skill that I acquired. I learned how to bake bread now. So my favorite bread is baguette, and now I can make baguette. Turns out that it's so simple to make.
Baguettes
only four
are...
ingredients.
Wow, okay. What are the four ingredients of baguettes?
Flour, yeast, a little bit of salt, and mm-hmm. water.
Wow.
Water, okay. That's it. No eggs, no milk, nothing. It's so good. So the flavor of the baguette comes from time. It takes 3 days to make. So you make a little bit, then you you know, let it rise, and then do it the next day, and then let it rise, and then... Yeah, and so the flavor comes from the fermentation. So it's so good, and it's so simple to make.
Are you selling this? Are you selling this online?
No, no.
We can make a living out of this, you know. I'll help you. Okay. Random fact number three.
Okay, I grew up in Roa City, Capiz, and I grew up in like the port area, and also like it's like a fishing area. And my family had a fish farm when I was growing up, mm-hmm. so we would spend summers in our fish farm. And so my first job was selling fish, like when we had a harvest, like, you know, pag may fish harvest kami, I would get my own what do you call it, parang thermo chest,
oh,
and I would
okay.
fill it with fish and then I would sell it to the people in our barangay.
Oh my god, napakagandang ano, napakagandang tindera ng isda naman dito.
That was my first thing. Like,
that's your first job, the very first job.
First job, yeah.
Okay, that's nice. Number four.
Okay, number four. I grew up in a family of musicians, so it was my Lola and my mom who taught me how to play guitar. So there was always music around the house, and yeah. So all the women in the house played guitar. So for me, it was like, it wasn't uncommon, you know, to see a girl playing guitar when I was young. So yeah.
It's like the most natural thing in the world. Because I saw in your Instagram, I stalk you, by the way, on Instagram. No, I saw in one of your concerts, but you performed on stage with your mom.
Oh, yeah, my mom.
That's your mom, right?
That's right.
You're like friends, huh? You're like my
Yeah, family. And that wasn't our... and that wasn't our first gig together. Like, because my very first gig ever was I played in my grade school. I was in high school now, but we had like a homecoming in grade school, in my grade school, and my mom and I were in a band together, and we were like a cover band of mga Guns N' Roses and Aerosmith and things like that. And my mom was a bass player in our first band. Okay. So, yeah,
that must have been awesome, you know, for you.
Oh yeah,
for you and your mom to bond with, you know, with all these songs and all
these definitely
performances.
Definitely.
Okay, yeah. So that's number five, na ba?
Number five
na tayo. Okay, what's number five?
All right. Well, number five is actually, it's not about me, but about my daughter, Stina. She has a very special skill or talent. She has synesthesia. So it's like when two of your synesthesia is when two of your senses kind of merge. Oh. So whenever she hears a note, like a musical note, like that, she sees a specific color in her mind.
There's a celebrity like that. Which one is it? I know I've heard
about
that.
There's a few. There's quite a few. Some people can, like, parang their taste buds and their, you know, their secret sound, mimic. So they taste something. When they hear something, they can taste. But yun, parang sa kanya, she sees colors whenever she hears music. So we discovered it when she was very young, mga 5 or ganon. Hindi pa siya marunong na ng mga musical chords or notes or anything, but whenever I would play a song, she would refer to it as a specific color, and then it turned out that it was consistent. She would say, like, this song is the color blue, or this song is the color orange, and yan. Now I ask her when I'm trying to learn a song and nahirapan ako, hanapin yung chords. Mm. Itatanong ko siya, anong kulay itong song na to? And then she'd.
Does she, like, when you play, do you simultaneously make her color, you know, in her sketchpad, maybe? No, not, I haven't tried
not,
that.
Not really, because it's not, I mean, she's also artistic. I mean, she loves to paint and ano, but the synesthesia, kasi it's just like, you know, when she hears a note, parang may certain ano daw. Of course, I can't see it, but she says na kunwari, if she hears the note C, meron lang white na flash on her mind.
There's
a white. So it's always a white. And then when she hears a D chord, it's a brown, like an F, it's a pink. So parang nagsiswirl. Have you seen the movie Ratatouille?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Yeah, there's a part there where he was talking about when they would mix food. And then when you mix food, parang it's like magic. And then all the colors were twirling around. They actually got an artist na may synesthesia to make that artwork part. So that's how it looks down in their brain, yung gumaganon yung colors.
Uh-huh.
So wow. Parang ganon yun. That's how the colors look.
That's beautiful. In one of your songs, maybe the music video would be like that. You know, just a splash of colors, you know, from your daughter, right? Okay, so thank you so much for those 5 random facts. Wow, what an icebreaker for this session, JuanOnOne Spotlight. Now, 5 things we want to know. This is our segment, guys. 5
Yeah,
people need to know about you as an artist. But before we move on to that, basically, Barbie, how are you in this pandemic, in this quarantine? How are you?
I'm holding up. like we were talking about earlier, we're doing online school with the kids, and we're doing a few like gigs like this, like work from home kind of gigs, which I enjoy kasi kahit paano nakakatugtog pa rin. Syempre, I can't wait for this to be over and, you know, for the old normal, for the new normal, for the real normal to be back. Mm-hmm. Yeah, to be back.
And to be able to get out there again.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Although I don't miss the traffic, of course.
Of course. That's right.
Siyempre, ano rin, up and down, may mga days na may anxiety, uncertainty, siyempre. And you need to find ways to pick yourself up and to continue staying hopeful and encouraged pa rin. Kasi may mga days talaga na parang...
You just want to scream, you know?
My husband was saying, ang tagal-tagal na!
The other day, I was just telling my daughter, I'm gonna explode. I'm so close, you know? There's an explosion coming out anytime soon. But you know what? The thing that I've learned in these interviews, in these things that we are doing with all of you, with all the musicians, with all the artists, you know, kasi I see you guys perform online and I'm thinking, oh, these guys are doing fine, you know, but the moment I talk to them, it's basically the same for everybody then. You know, everybody's going through. It's a different kind of thing lang for everybody. But you know, we're all going through this. You know, in that sense, we are together, I guess. You know, in that sense. So So since you're home, since you're not going out, what are you working on right now? I mean, what are you working on in terms of music?
Yeah, in terms of, I've been recording at home, and so practically finished the album, but we're releasing them as single. So we just started with a new single that we released last month, and we'll be releasing more songs. Mm-hmm. And then doing ganyan, mga gigs na online. I also play music sa worship team namin sa church, so I also serve there, and then that's it. Just making. I'm happy to still be able, to make music, and also grateful that one of my bandmates. So I have three bandmates, and grateful that one of them lives next door, so we still get to jam.
Ang bilis.
Si Karel, he lives there, so he's my brother-in-law. So ayun, at least may bandmate ako dito. Oh. Kasi yun nga. May other bandmates sa videos na kami nakikita.
Ah, okay. That's nice. At least you still get to do your work and the thing that you love, right? Now, is the thing that we're seeing right now in your background, is that your studio? Is that like a corner of your house or of your room? Is it a made-up studio, or has it always...
Yeah, it's a made-up. No, this didn't exist pre-lockdown, this area. This is like, it is the corner of our bedroom, actually. It's by the window. Mm-hmm. But I did this table is like where I really like, spend, I would read and stuff here on this table. Kasi nga, it's facing trees outside. So, yeah. Pero yan, yung mga lights dyan, tong acoustic panels and stuff. Sinatap ko lang to para yun nga, pag may recording and ano. So, this is now my corner.
Oh, and it will be soon. I mean, it will be forever.
I think
lot of us have converted corners or rooms in our houses, no? Since even those who are not artists, even those who are like working from home lang office, they've made this corner and made things soundproof, because not everybody has nice dogs for neighbors. You know, some of them bark throughout the day. In this pandemic, in this quarantine, what's the most difficult part that you've encountered?
Syempre yung ano talaga, yung loss, 'di ba? There's just grabe lang, talagang profound yung loss na ano natin as a planet, 'di ba? Ang dami nating
collective.
And the longer it has been, parang the closer that the virus is getting, right? Parang dati you hear about it from afar, and then next time, a classmate of yours lost a family member, and then later mamaya a cousin gets the virus, mamaya a lolo, parang talagang ano na, parang
it gets closer to home.
It gets closer to home. Ngayon, dami ko nang kilala na, alam mo yon, lost someone or got the virus, and of course parang tingin mo sometimes, because we're going through it all together, parang feeling mo na may minimize, pero hindi mo makakalculate ng ganun eh. Di ba? Kasi minsan, pag if somebody lost a parent, parang, and if they're the only one who has, then parang it's such a big deal. But now it's like everybody, it's happening so many. So parang feeling mo, it's parang nagiging number, you know what I mean? Parang siya, and then, but in the perspective of that family, they lost, somebody close to them. It's
not just a number.
It doesn't lessen the blow, So, yun talaga, that's what we're praying for. We're praying na matapos na to, and that we'll be safe, na hindi na magdagdagan yung... But I think, ano naman din, right? Na parang, we're dealing with it better nowadays. Maybe because of science, because of, so nagiging, I guess not... I'm not sure if my facts are straight, but I think yun nga, nagiging less... yung mortality rate or
that's
things
true.
Like that. In the beginning kasi malaki eh. So ngayon parang maraming nagkakaroon ng COVID, pero yun nga, marami sa kanila asymptomatic na, or it's they yeah. So yun talaga. That's the hardest thing. I pray will be over soon, yeah.
And what's the easiest part of living like this? Like, was there a Was there beauty in it, or was there a positive thing?
Silver lining. Well, yeah. I said,
silver lining.
That was okay. Kasi parang ano, kasi oh, sige, hindi. sabagay. parang ano na, at least there's something na a little yeah. bit na makukuha mong positive din. It's not like the...
Get. What is it?
Well, of course, sabi ko nga yung traffic. As in, that's one of the things talaga na, man, I've been living in Manila since the late 90s. Mm-hmm. So 20 years na, and the traffic situation has just gotten worse, right? And yun, isa yun talaga sa mga things that na hindi ko nami-miss at sana yun nga sana matapos din. Yeah.
Sana
so
wala.
I even with the kids online school, I'm grateful that they don't have to, you know, wake up so early and then go through traffic to go to school. Mm-hmm. I'm grateful that, you know, they can wake up and be in school right away. And then that also that I can do like this, like a radio interview straight out of the shower.
That's true, right?
And like, I'm an interview, wait, shower lang ako. Dito na.
And there are so many filters now, di ba? Parang you don't have to put on your makeup, may filter na.
Oh, wala na, yan na. Ano na lang yun? Ilawan mo na lang.
That's right. That's the beauty in this, you know, at least in the work that we have, right? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, now third segment na tayo. Okay, third segment. Random questions lang din. For kanina, random facts. Now, random questions. Okay, so parang fast lang to. I'll give you like, probably if you want to think, mga 3 seconds to think. Okay. Which comes first, music or lyrics?
Music. Yeah. Although they're usually sabay, but the chords come first. Then the melody and the lyrics go together.
Okay, so music first. Spam or maling?
Spam.
Spam yun eh. Slowly, very slowly, but yes. Okay. Would you rather walk or ride a bike? Pick only one.
Oh. Oh,
like if
ride
you're
a bike.
Buy suka from the canto. Ride a bike. You'd rather
ride
a bike.
Oh, I love riding. I love bikes and skateboards and things like that.
Oh, you love things with wheels. Nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Recording or performing?
You know what? Recording.
Recording. You like recording than performing.
But I like them both. I like them both, but I love the creative process. Yan.
Pareta, antisocial.
may pressure kasi. Hindi ako marunong mag-spill. Nahirapan ako mag-spill. So, akala ko dati, pag you know, like my friend and I were talking about this. I mean, parang feeling ng mga taong may banda, parang porket you can sing, you can already spill. Mm-hmm. I mean, no. you have to practice for your spills too, because you should like say the same thing over and over, because yun nga, hindi ako marunong mag-spill. Akala ko dati, it will come out naturally, you know, the moment you're on stage.
Yeah. Para stand-up comedians. Well, even the stand-up comedians, they write, they have a script that they follow,
yun
right?
Yun nga. Yeah, but musicians take it for granted. Because we're just thinking about focus on the music, and then you get to the stage and you're like, you have to talk in between songs. So now it's like, oh man.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ito na yung susunod na kanta, guys. Kanta lang tayo. Okay.
Yeah, laging ganun.
Diba? Kanta tayo. Next song. Okay. Speaking of songs, first 3 songs on your playlist right now. Like today lang, sige. Let's go as...
Well, right now, we have a family. We listen on Alexa, and right now, all the playlists there are all Japanese anime music.
Like, oh, that's nice.
Because our kids are so into it, so we're listening to Gurenge by Lisa and mga ganon. And then the whole like Naruto.
Baby Met, ganyan.
OST, mga ganon. Yun yung music namin sa bahay. Dahil,
wow.
Yun nga.
Pati yung Netflix ni din puro Japanese cartoons.
Yeah, the kids Netflix, yeah. Kami naman ni Martin, when we watch pag sa gabi na mga ano naman kami, mga spy, mga ganun.
What I love about these Japanese cartoons, they're like so warm. The stories are so warm.
That's true. Yeah, yung makikita mo yung values ng in Japanese culture, it's ano rin.
And even when you read their books, it's really, you know, nothing is lost in translation, even if it's translated in English. Ang galing, no? Anyway. Yeah. Moving on.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Yeah, what's, no, on? No, but,
Ano tawag doon?
Ano ba tawag doon? Otaku. You're a...
Otaku!
You're a fan, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Parang ano lang, anong tawag doon pagka you like English stuff? Anglo, I forgot.
Anglophobe? Ah, no, Anglophile.
Anglophile, yeah. Anglophile. Yeah. Okay, so, okay, moving on, guys. Medyo nagkakaroon kami na conversations dito. What's on your cart? Like, huwag na natin sabihin kung ano, online shopping service. Pero, what's on your cart right now? Like, siguro first items on your cart.
I just finished. I have nothing on my cart currently.
Wow.
The last thing I bought was cat food this morning.
Okay. And then, is it on the way na to deliver?
It arrived na just an hour ago. And then I bought a weighing scale for like the kitchen, you know, for my baking needs. Yeah.
Yes.
That was my one of the last things I put.
I love those things. Those little, weighing scales. They give you so much pleasure, you know, when you know what you're eating. okay, it's this much. Okay, that's good. Yeah. All right, quarantine questions. Next quarantine questions talaga. How's the household like this quarantine?
Oh, well, it's a bit messy because everybody's here. I'm the one picking up after, well, I also have help, but like with the kids. But with the kids, alam mo yon, parang guguluhin, tapos ayusin ko, tapos guguluhin, ayusin ko. But,
yeah.
But at the same time, I also leave it be rin kasi nga, yun eh, parang nandito kami the whole day and we want them to be busy and be creative din. So, hinayaan ko rin sa kanil, sila mag-bake ng mess and, you know, may mga Lego na nakakalat dyan.
Oh. Sakit sa paano, natatapakan
mo. Hindi, ginawa ko may blanket. Yung isang actually ano ang tawag doon yung sa table yung cloth sa tablecloth a round tablecloth I put it on the floor and that's where the Lego pile is inside the tablecloth so
at boundary
may boundary yun sabi ko yung rules keep the Legos inside the cloth and then at the end you just wrap it like that and put it in the bin so because this was after like I don't know how many times I had to pick up Lego and then put it in the bin by hand so kaya yun nga.
Yeah. Then, so anything that comes out of the perimeter, we'll throw it in the trash can.
Yeah, ganun.
Okay, and then?
Yun din. Syempre ngayon din, yun nga, yung panahon nga rin na you have to practice extra grace and patience towards each other. Kasi, di ba, minsan, lagi kayo magkasama, di ba, 24/7. So, also, kailangan ko rin to let the kids be and, wag masyadong maging... maging
control.
Nagger.
Yeah.
Maging control. Kasi
maging control.
Makikita mo lahat. So parang, realize ko, kailangan din namin ng magbigay ng grace sa isa't isa.
Grace and space.
So, syempre, some days are easier, some days are like,
yeah.
But yeah, luluhod ka talaga. Pray, right? Parang,
not every day is the same. Okay, so I can see, I can see in your story sometimes that your kids are also, of course, that your kids are in music, but which came first, you teaching them music or them coming to you and asking to be taught?
I think the first is iingitin mo sila. So parang just surrounding them, you're just like having, hey, I'm having fun with
lure
music.
Them.
So yeah, ganun lang, like letting them see that it's fun. And so the music teaching only came later on. Ito lang ano na lang. Like no one they start sila mag-piano lesson and I'm currently teaching my son guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Pero ano pa eh kasi parang wala pa they do enjoy it. But of course, hindi pa siya dumadating sa stage na alam niyo sobrang love nila yung instrument na talagang they can't put it down. Wala pa. So medyo may konting carrot and stick pa kami na parang whole carrot. if you practice, pero sila ano checklist. Kasi nauna tinatamad-tamad eh. Parang sabi ko, you practice guitar 10 minutes ha, mamaya kukuha pa lang ng guitar, nagbibilang na ng oras. Parang, ganun.
Just
10 minutes na ba? 10 minutes, ganun. So sabi ko, okay. Yan. So sabi ko may surprise. Sabi ko, yan. After ano, if you practice consistently for 3 weeks, ganyan, may checklist siya. Binibilang niya kung naka 3 weeks na siya. Kasi may surprise siya sa dulo. So ngayon, nagpapanik siya ngayon pag ano, yung son ko, nagpapanik siya. I forgot guitar! So nagkukunin yung guitar niya, papractice niya talaga. Kasi excited siya makuha yung prize niya.
Oh,
sabi ko, okay lang yan. Kahit na wrong motives muna, okay lang muna. So, at least, makikita niya na, kasi may talent siya eh. Kaya lang, alam mo yun, Kasi wala pa eh. Siyempre, wala pa kasi yung ano eh. Ako din naman, high school na ako nakahanap ng music na sobrang love ko eh.
Yes.
So, ngayon may pagka-chore. Kasi tell them, it feels like a chore right now, but you know, it's gonna pay off.
Yeah, they're gonna thank you when they're all grown up. I mean, you never really appreciate the piano lessons that you had as a kid until you grow up and, you know,
yeah,
start being recognized for your talents. That's what I told them. That's what I told them. About. Alam mo, kung gusto mo talaga mag-gitara, hindi mo matatagal yung gitara sa katawan mo. Okay? Nakadikit lang yung palagi. Di ba? If you're really serious about it, tell me you're serious about it. Because you know how kids are? They like shiny new things and I want this one. And then when you bring them home, exactly. they don't play with it. So, yeah tama yan, carrot and stick.
Ganun muna.
Now, I know you're picking up things after, you know, the people in the house, but do you have a fitness routine apart from, you know, picking things up from the floor?
Yes. my husband has been like, you know, prodding me to do any exercise for so many years. Kasi siya, ganun siya, nagbabox, nag-gym. Mm-hmm. Ako talagang wala, zero before. Pero nung nag-start yung itong bagong
new normal.
New normal. Yeah, nung nag-start ito, for the first few weeks, may time na, syempre, di ba nawala lahat ng schedule?
Yes.
So, nasira rin lahat ng tulog. Parang, alam mo yun, wala kang routine eh. So, may mga 2 weeks na hindi ako nakakita ng sun halos kasi nagigising ako ng hapon. Parang ganun. So, parang unhealthy na talaga. So, I started playing, just shooting hoops, basketball yun sa likod. And then, meron yung, my sister-in-law and her husband, they're into swimming talaga. So, and there's a little pool in the back there in our compound. Mm. Maliit lang siya, so hindi ka talaga pwede mag-laps. Pero, maliit lang, parang tatlong ganun mo lang nasa dulo ka na eh. So, yung ginawa nila, well, I think they found it online that they tied a rope to a tree. Mm-hmm. And then on the other end of the rope, they put a rubber, an elastic, parang exercise band. Mm-hmm. So you wrap the exercise band on your, dito.
On your waist?
So waist mo. And then you have a pool treadmill. So now, you can swim for however long you want and you're not moving. So yun, so nag-start yun ng swimming thing. So that's been our fitness thing for the family. Halos like every day or every other day, nagkayayaan na mag-swim. And then tinuruan nila kami paano mag, you know, the proper freestyle, mga gano'n. So yun na lang, yun. So now I have a fitness routine. It's swimming.
That's nice. That's a nice fitness routine. Ang galing. Skincare routine naman. Kasi ito na skin ko eh. I mean, it's not just the lighting Barbie. It's really...
Parang ako mag-ilaw, ayan o.
It's not just the lighting Barbie. It's really nice skin. Okay, what's your skincare routine? Everybody wants to know.
I think you have to hydrate. Like, I drink a lot of water. Mm-hmm. And then, I use just my Cetaphil, like the cleanser.
Uh-huh.
And that's it. That's it.
Wow, very simple.
No, I know I need to use moisturizer and stuff. But hindi, kailangan ko actually ng tips sa mga kasi may mga friends ako magaling sila sa mga serum, mga moisturizers. I do need it, but I just yun nga, parang tamad din siguro ako when it comes to mga ganon. Mm-hmm. Mga
okay yan, hydrate. Okay yan, hydrate and wash your face. Yes.
Yeah, wash your face but not too much. Like twice a day lang.
Okay, so now that, you know, you've been there for a long time in your house like everybody else, where would you want to perform first when we get out there?
I don't know. Any gig will do.
Kahit saan!
basta magkakasama kami ng band and yun nga, makakakita ng mga tao.
Yeah, and then the energy, no? And then the new energy na nasa labas
yeah.
to perform. Okay, if there's a song that you're gonna play for us right now, for everybody who's listening, who's watching, what would it be and why?
Well, we just released our version of Umagang Kay Ganda. Ito lang, last month. And I think it's it has a timeless message. And totoo yung message niya of hope. Mm-hmm. And kaya, you know, tingin ko, you know, it's a song na makaka-encourage din ng iba when they hear it. Na, yun, na we just have to continue working together and... Kasi pwede kang mag-drown in despair din, di ba? Dahil nga sa ano natin, sa situation. Pero Hope is important. Actually, when you have hope, you know, you think differently, you live differently, you hold on differently, and it really does make a difference in our lives, yung ano natin, yung perspective natin. So, yun lang. So I want to share umagang kay ganda.
Okay. And on that note, thank you so much, Barbie, for being a part of JuanOnOne Spotlight. Please continue supporting
thank
our
you,
local
Jada.
Musicians. Yes, follow their accounts and requests for their music or for their songs in our station. This special is brought to you by the radio stations under the Philippine Broadcasting Service, Republica FM1, FM1 Davao, Capital FM2, RP1, and RP2. Barbie, why don't you invite them to check out your social media accounts, and if you have online gigs, what lang yung meron sa other station? Sige, can you invite our viewers and our listeners?
Well, thank you all for having me today, and I want to invite you to follow me on all my socials. It's just Barbie Almalbis on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Okay, thank you so much, Barbie.
Spotify also.
Spotify also you have.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Barbie. Stay safe. See you
in the
studio soon, okay?
Yes.
Boys and girls, take care, you too. Boys and girls, time to enjoy Umagang Kay Ganda by Barbie Almalbis for JuanOnOne Spotlight. This is Republica FM1.
Halika na, pumiti, imuti ng problema. Hinihintayin ang umaga. Magpahinga, panaginip ang ikaligaya. Narating
at a time. Listen to Artist Under the Limelight on JuanOnOne Spotlight.